Alright, here we are for round four. We're on the draw, and this hand tests even my ability to keep anything. So I think we should mulligan. This one, on the other hand, on the draw with a scry land, I think I'm okay with keeping. It's not an amazing hand by any means, because we have two copies of a legend, and we only have one land. But we do have a one mana removal spell and a two drop. So if we can curve out, this hand is actually great. So I'm going to keep it. There we go, step one. Lightning Strike. I think we just bottom it. I think the upside of hitting our third land is so high that we want to maximize the chance of that. Alright. I guess we should play a Plains now. It's not a huge difference, but... So it looks like our opponent is probably Jeskai Tokens, which is a medium matchup in my experience. They have few ways to answer Stormbreath, but also their threats are pretty hard for us to deal with, like our removal is not very efficient. Okay, so guess I'd rather, if he's gonna kill one of my guys, I'd rather him kill Brimaz, because we have another one, so I'll just play Brimaz this turn. Can always Rabble Master next turn. Okay. This is going to be a pretty good turn for us. So I think I'd rather kill... I guess I'd rather kill the Goblin, because... I think next one we're going to play Rabble Master and chain his Rabble Master, so we'd rather kill off his Goblin. Just because it's red, mostly. This is the kind of time when Chain of the Rocks really shines. And now it feels like even if he has a Jeskai Ascendancy or something, it's going to be too late. He'd have to pay two life to play it, and then we'd just get to attack with everything, and he'd probably have to lose all of his creatures. Alright, so that makes me think he has a Stoke. Oh, I guess not. Okay. So we'll go ahead and just block with Brimaz. Expected him to have a Stoke there and tap all of his guys. I think that would have been a pretty good turn for him. But this is not such a big problem for us. So I guess we'll just go ahead and attack with everyone. Definitely attacking with all of these. The only question is if we want to attack with Rabble Master or not. He could trade Rabble Masters with us. He could trade two soldiers for our Rabble Master and block that one. I think I would rather protect our Rabble Master. The ideal would be if he quad blocks Brimaz, and then we can just play another one. This is fine too, though. We're still netting a token per combat. Things are still definitely going well. We do not need another land, on the other hand. Definitely just blocking with Brimaz again. It's totally fine if he has Lightning Strike. I guess I should block with Brimaz and Rabble Master in case he wants to stoke Brimaz or something. The downside of him, like, potentially having Chandra to ping our Rabble Master is just not that high. As compared to if he kills our Brimaz and then gets to keep a token and somehow parlays that into generating a lot of tokens, which would be the most annoying. And obviously, yeah, so it looks like he's going for a Lightning Strike on Brimaz, which is definitely fine. We have another one to follow up with, so that's A-okay with me. This point, we just have to decide again if we want to attack with Rabble Master. If we do, he could block four. He could block Rabble Master with two soldiers and block one here and take four, or he could trade Rabble Masters and block two and take three. I think at this point it's worth attacking with it. I think he's almost certainly priced into blocking it, which is definitely good for us. Alright, he's going for the two soldiers there and the one there. Puts him to five. Think, yeah, that's fine. Play Brimaz and play our land. And that leaves us in a very threatening position. He's also now going to have a hard time cracking this Flooded Strand or tapping these Sheevan Reefs for anything other than colorless because his life total is so low. It's funny we kept a one lander this game. I don't think we've missed a land drop yet. Alright, so he went for a treasure cruise, which almost certainly means he's dead. Alright, well. Yeah, I guess the downside of showing him Stormbreath is probably not worth the potential upside of guaranteeing that we win absolutely no matter what, even though I think we were probably going to win anyway. So for sideboarding in this matchup, I don't really like Chain of the Rocks because the only creature it can effectively hit is Rabble Master, which admittedly he had that game. I also don't like Hushwing Griff and I don't like Ashcloud Phoenix because none of them block tokens well. Chandra's good, Scouring Sands is good. I think Glare of Heresy is good. And I guess we'll leave in one Chain of the Rocks. At the GP, obviously, I only had one Ashcloud Phoenix, so I had one fewer card to take out. So I like having this many answers. This way we have five answers to Rabble Master, which I think is probably a good number. Glare is nice because it can hit both Seeker of the Way and Ascendancy. And like, maybe if they board into Wingmate Rock or whatever, something like that. It's good to have a versatile answer. So let's give this a whirl.